Take a break from your addiction by becoming tobacco-free.
There are a lot of people that are trying to quit smoking. Quitting is a good idea for yourself and for the people around you. The messages are out there. They're hearing the messages from the media, on the radio, and on TV, and in print. And I'm so pleased with that. Some people don't realize that it's easy to become addicted. Smoking is not a habit. Smoking is an addiction. In the brain, there are pleasure centers and a nicotine receptor. When you smoke, nicotine goes from mouth to brain in as little as 7 to 10 seconds. It goes to the pleasure center of the brain, so your body likes that feeling. You get a high, and of course, you do come down. And with each puff, you do get another high, and then you come down. So when somebody's gone to sleep for a night and they wake up in the morning, they're looking for the high. So some people need a cigarette right away. There's many parts to smoking. There is the physical addiction, there is the habit itself. So people have learned that I have my cigarette with my coffee, I have my cigarette after dinner, I have my cigarette before I go into work. So behaviors are part of the addiction itself. Cigarette smoke has 4,000 chemicals. 250 of those chemicals are known to be harmful. 50 of those chemicals are known to contribute to cancer. A lung that's infected with because of smoking due to tar is much different than a healthy lung. You can see the striations, you can see some hard sections on the lung as well, because there could be cancerous there. We know that secondhand smoke affects the children and affects your partner as well. For children, asthma and breathing difficulties are some of the results. For women, breast cancer has been linked with secondhand smoke. The woman doesn't have to smoke herself to have chances of getting breast cancer. Smoke also affects cervical cancer in women. And in men, erectile dysfunction is one of the side effects of smoking. There are many reasons people want to quit smoking. Their doctor may say, you need to quit because of this health condition or that health condition. A surgeon may say, I cannot perform the surgery unless you quit because the outcome after surgery won't be very good. Money is another issue for other people. Teens realize that that's a lot of money coming from their pocket and they want to spend their money on going out with their friends. The health of someone's children or grandchildren, that's another reason people may want to quit smoking. Insurance, house insurance is different and car insurance can be different for those who smoke and for those who don't smoke because of health reasons and also reasons related to fire. If someone decides they want to quit smoking, one of the first things they can do is make sure their house is smoke-free. Get rid of the ashtrays. Try and get rid of the smoking in your car and smoking in your home. Vacuum the home so it smells nice and fresh. Consider using a quit smoking aid, nicotine gum, nicotine inhaler, nicotine patches, or nicotine lozenge. You can talk to your doctor about the pills that help you, and your pharmacist can be of help with the two pills that helping people to quit smoking. Maybe you don't need a quit smoking aid. Maybe you need some self-help, you want to read a book. There are books called For Smokers Who Don't Want to Quit, that's stage one, and For Smokers Who Want to Quit, stage 2 to 5. Some people can quit smoking the first time they try. Most people need to try more than once. The average is between 4 and 6 times that people try to quit smoking and they are affected. They are successful in quitting smoking. You continue to try because you're teaching your body new habits. The hand-to-mouth habit is one, and also reducing the nicotine that goes from your mouth to your brain in 7 to 10 seconds. It is a process, it's not a one-time activity. A person who's tried and relapses, that's okay. You try again. You've learned what works for you and what doesn't work, and you continue to try.